Morning, guys. So it's June 24th, 2023. Out here in Sousa's garage, out here in Ruston, Rhode Island. So I pulled the vacuum pump, the vacuum motor out of the 48. This is for the wipers. And just wanted to see if I could get it to work. Not that I could use it. You can't run the vacuum pump off of the throttle body injected motor, fuel injected motors very easily. It's a pain in the butt. There's a part. It really works. The key action on this is the agitation action. It just goes back and forth. So, what I did was I just so I could test it, I sprayed some silicone in it, just to clean up the interior. Then I noticed when I put my finger over the, I can actually get it to feel it sucking. So, that means that actually this probably is easily restorable. It's probably not full of crap. I think it has like a leather gasket that separates it. There's an arm in there that goes back and forth, and the valve basically just puts the vacuum from one side to the other, which makes it sweep across. So it's a vacuum, but it's not what I need. So my question is, do I get online and order me up a China motor? No. Nope. And that's really all I've really found was China motors. So what I decided to do was see if I can modify a 1990s Chevrolet motor. So, got low gear, got high gear, that's all I need. Now the action is different on this. You can see that it goes around in a circle. So I'm gonna have to build the wipers differently to work like a more modern system where both of the arms come together to this central pivot point. And I'll have to figure that point out, how far out it'll be, so that I'm not going out past the windshield with the wiper. Obviously the windshields were bigger with these, but I'll figure that ratio out by taking the vacuum motor and measuring the total distance that it travels from here to there in an arc. Once I figure that out, I'll be able to modify this arm to hold those. So it's going to be a work. It's going to be a work in progress. It's going to be a little bit of trial and error, but I don't know. When I bought the other motor, bought the motor for the 54 rat rod, when I got it, I hooked it in, and the wipers didn't even cover the window. I ended up having to extend this to get, so I had to modify the brand spanking new motor to get it to work. So, you know, I mean, come on. Yeah, you see, I'm going to be installing these. I'm putting the clear on it to get it watertight. Problem I had with these before when I did it was that I didn't get enough clear on them, and the moisture got into them and over time broke them down. So the ones I did before on another truck only lasted about 5 years. I think I got the water pump issue taken care of now. I still got that clicking noise in that AC compressor. I'm going to see if I can find the pulley that replaces, when you don't have air conditioner, it's just a pulley that goes here. I'm going to look online and see if I can find that. If I'm not sure I'm going to be able to find that out in the junkyard, because nowadays they take all the engines out of the vehicles as soon as they get them. They don't put the cars out in the fields with the powertrains in them. They drain all the fluids, pull everything out, and it's all about, you know, keeping the ground clean. So finding, plus, yards around here, man, they sell the motor. The motor's like the most valuable part, the engine and tranny. So out from Rusty, Rhode Island, where things are looking good on a rainy day.